And you are still with Nightline. KwaZulu-Natal teacher Kangelani Sbia has scooped an international award at the Global Education Network gathering recently. Sbia teaches at Spumelele Secondary School. That's in Newcastle. He was selected from 80 of the top teachers in the world. Kangelani is joining us now from our Durban studios to talk about the award and his passion for education. Kangelani, a very good evening to you, and thank you for your time. Firstly, congratulations to you. A global teaching award. Did you ever think you'd win one?
Well, thank you very much. Maybe the first thing that I want to start with, I'm from Richards Bay, basically in one of the schools, Pumele Secondary School. But then your question to say, you know, I never thought of this, but then because of the work that I'm doing, people, they will keep on saying, if I can apply or if one can nominate me globally, then obviously they can recognize my work.
And what stood out about your method, because you are a math and science teacher, is that you've managed to incorporate modern trends, be it dance and music, in your instruction. How exactly do you do that?
Basically, what I understood is that kids are saying or are having the stigma of saying mathematics and science is a difficult or are a difficult subject. Then what came into my mind was that if I can come up with the approach that can make them understand mathematics. So hence, as a result, I decided to come up to say, I know kids, they like music, they like to sing, they like dances. So then I started to relate the two. To say if for an example, they want to find a certain, for example, if we're looking at the calculus, if they are looking for the turning point, then if we can sing the steps of calculating the turning point. Again, if we're looking at physical science for the definition, for an example, if they can sing the definition, then that would make them recall when they come to exams.
And how much has that changed attitudes among the pupils that you interact with? Because I remember when I was in high school, math and science, as is still the case with many other teenagers to this day, were not the favorite subjects to take.
Yes, it because of the stigma of what I understand, because if the learner, for example, says mathematics, it's a difficult subject, obviously it will be difficult indeed. But then if us as teachers, we change our approach in terms of delivering the content, that can change everything. Because what I normally do, I normally take them to what they normally or what they like. For example, as I indicated, if you look at the soccer, because I know they like sports, if you relate the sign of the different big teams, for example, if you take Orlando Pirates, then if you look at the sign for Orlando Pirates, you can see there are vertical opposite angles there. And as Mamelodi Sundowns is the sign for the Mamelodi Sundowns, you can see the seven there, and the angle between the two fingers is a right angle. So then if you multiply the two gradients, the product would be negative one. So if we relate all of that, obviously the mind or the stigma of saying mathematics is a difficult subject, obvious, it changes. So basically that is what I normally do. And I also compile some documents which simplify the content, the difficult chapters like Euclid and geometry, because I know very well that that chapter, they find it very difficult to them. But then if we sing some of the important things, to say if the lines are parallel, then they only alternate if two lines are parallel. So if we also sing all those things, then it makes them understand very clear. So as a result, plus or minus people that 25,000 people that I interacted with in the world, they now like mathematics. So that is what makes me keep on pushing to say I have to keep on using this approach, because they now enjoy mathematics.
I think I'm still a lost cause when it comes to mathematics, but we are at the end of the year. Soon we'll be seeing the matric results come out, and as always there'll be a conversation about how we can improve the quality of our education system and indeed the work that you do as an educator. If you were to give advice to the powers that be in the education sector, what would you say needs to happen to make sure that we have as conducive an environment as possible for both pupils and yourselves as teachers?
Basically, what I can say, since I was in Dubai, when we were having some discussion with other teachers from other countries, I noted that, in fact, we all have the same challenges in our educational system. Maybe to mention a few, we have the common challenge, which is language barrier, culture, assessment, and also the parent involvement as far as teaching and learning is concerned, of which if we can form a sort of the forum whereby we sit together as teachers, together with parents, to look at the solutions in the challenges that I have mentioned, to have the common goal, to say for the parents, for those parents that are not taking serious of their children's education, what is it that can be done? And in terms of assessment, what is it that is expected? How, as teachers, can we communicate with the parents in order to make sure that even the curriculum is being covered? Because as teachers, we still have a problem of those kids who are not attending extra classes, everything like that. So if we can have a forum whereby we will discuss all of these challenges and come up with solutions or different solutions, I think that can change everything around.
Kangelani Sibiya, once again, congratulations to you, and thank you so much for all the incredible work that you do with those young people in your community. Let's move on to the